So the Emergency Paid Sick Leave Act, it covers all employees, doesn't matter how long they worked for you. And it, again, applies to employers with fewer than 500 employees. Full-time employees are permitted 80 hours of paid leave, and it's calculated at the regular rate of pay. Part-time employees, there's an averaging that employers have to do to figure out how much the part-time employees are owed. Now, we're talking about the paid sick leave. It's important to keep the two leaves distinct. So this is the emergency paid sick leave, not the emergency FMLA expansion act. So under the paid sick leave, there's six covered reasons that the employee can take leave that could potentially be paid. So the first reason is the employee is subject to a federal, state, or local quarantine or isolation order related to COVID-19, and they're unable to work. The second reason is the employee has been advised by a healthcare provider to self-quarantine due to concerns related to COVID-19. And the third one is that the employee's is experienced symptoms of COVID-19 and seeking a medical diagnosis. So these first three covered reasons for a leave, the employee is paid all of their pay at the regular rate of pay. The next three reasons for leave are paid at the employee's two-thirds of the employee's regular rate of pay. So there on the screen, and the fourth reason is that the employee is caring for an individual who is subject to an order, as described in section one, or has been advised in paragraph two, reason two up above. The fifth reason is the employee is caring for a son or daughter. If the school or place of care of the son or daughter has been closed due to COVID-19 precautions. And the sixth reason is a little vague. We're looking for the Secretary of Labor to come out with some clarification on this substantially similar condition specified by the Secretary of Health and Human Services. So, and these leaves, they are subject to caps too. So the first three reasons for a leave subject to a $511 per day cap and a $5,110 in the aggregate cap. And the for reasons four through six, it's subject to a $200 per day cap and a $2,000 in the aggregate cap for the paid sick leave. Now there is a notice requirement under the paid sick leave, this emergency paid sick leave. The employers have to provide a notice to employees in their normal place where they post these types of things. The Department of Labor is supposed to come out with this week, this notice. So that will be available for employers to post. Now, moving on to the Emergency Family and Medical Leave Expansion Act. Again, it applies to employers with fewer than 500 employees. And the eligible employees is an employee who has been employed for at least 30 calendar days. So it changes the normal requirements for coverage under the FMLA. They only have to be employed by the employer for the last 30 calendar days. Now, there's only one qualified reason that the employee gets paid leave under this emergency FMLA expansion leave, and it's when the employee is unable to work or telework due to the need for a leave to care for a child that's under the 18 years is under 18 years old. And if the employee if the school or place of care has been closed for the child. So that's the only qualifying reason under the Emergency FMLA Expansion Act. Now, under the FMLA Expansion Act, the amount of paid leave, the first 10 days are unpaid, and then after that, the employee is paid at two-thirds of the regular rate of pay. And then there is a cap on this too. It doesn't exceed $200 per day and $10,000 in the aggregate. The employee has certain reinstatement rights once they take this leave. And there is an exclusion. We're getting a lot of questions about this for employers with less than 50 employees, but it's not an automatic exclusion. Employers have to apply for that exclusion, be granted that exclusion by the Secretary of Labor. So we have to approach that carefully. Just don't assume because you have less than 50 employees that you're excluded. And the employers are going to have to show that complying with this Paid Sick Leave Act would jeopardize the viability of the business as a going concern and enable that exclusion. So who's going to pay for all of this right now? The burdens on the businesses to pay for this leave. And I see we're already getting a lot of questions through the comments here on the webinar today that it's going to be a really tough. If a restaurant's been forced to close, doesn't have any cash, how are they supposed to come up with cash for employees? Now there's a tax credit that the government has said it's going to cover 100% of this, but that tax credit won't come back to the employers for some time. And if you're closed, it's going to be really difficult to comply with this. And so there's you need to look at it carefully in a lot of different scenarios on how this plays out. And we'll talk about some of these strategies here too today, what employers are doing to tighten their belts with the economic downturn and some strategies on this.